What is up, guys, and welcome back to a brand new video on this beautiful, beautiful, beautiful channel. Guys, today we have a bit of a long video ahead of us, I know. But I have to say I really enjoy long videos because I usually, well, not usually, always when I'm eating, I am watching YouTube. So I usually enjoy like 20 to 30 or 40 minute videos because that is the ideal length for like... I don't know, for lunch, mostly lunch, yeah, mostly lunch, maybe even breakfast, but I usually do not eat breakfast or just something very little. So yeah, today we have a interview you guys told me is really interesting, and I was like a second away from watching it on my own, but I thought let's just record it and let me share my reaction, my thoughts with this. So, sorry if this is like a bit of a long video, as I said, because I may add some thoughts of my own to one or two questions. Okay, so this is the Grammy interview from the Grammy Museum, and it has English subs, so I figured it is better when we have English subs. Good, I'm excited, guys. If you want to watch more interview reactions of me to BTS, check out the playlist and the information card, guys. Good. Let's do it. I'm excited. I'm actually excited. How old is it? A year. Well, a year and a half.
Okay. Would you please welcome BTS?
Oh, there's an audience. There is an audience. I didn't know that. Okay, that is interesting. Okay. Hobi with the brightest smile possible. Okay, they're all looking good as usual.
Thank you. Birthday!
Happy birthday.
Ha! This feels a little strange to me, so I'm gonna move up a little bit here. So,
okay.
Yeah.
First of all, thank you very much. For being
Thank
here.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for having us, sir.
I know that
Namjoon again with the sir. He's so polite. He's so polite.
Has been quite busy, so we appreciate your taking the time to join us here at the Grammy Museum. You just finished 4, I think, sold out shows across the street at the Staples Center. So what was different this time in terms of the performance at the Staples Center than your last visit? What did you? What was different about? Did you get a different experience or a different sense of feedback from the audience?
사실 가장 큰 차이는 그거죠. 이제 우리가 스테이플 센터에서 네 번을 공연을 했다는 게 가장 큰 yeah. 차이인 것 같고, 그리고 그 공연장에서 이제 많은 팬 여러분들과 함께 뭔가 이 새 앨범으로 뭔가 이렇게 저희의 곡들을 들려줄 수 있다는 게
It must be so exciting.
큰 뭔가 다른 점인 것 같고요. 그리고 많은 부분들이 있었던 것 같아요. 일단은 되게 yeah. 이번에 자신감이 좀 많았었던 것 같아요.
I like 스테이지. I like Jin and Jimin wearing the same like shirt. Kind of like his is more bluish.
이제 관련해서 많은 분들이 열광하고 이런 부분에서 좋아해 주신다는 거에 대해서 그 스테이지에 저희가 굉장히 많은 참여를 하고 그랬기 때문에 그 무대에 대해서 굉장히 자신감이 있었던 것 같아요. 그런 부분에
yeah,
대해서 이번 스테이플 센터 4회 공연은
I mean, Staples Center is huge. The Staples Center is huge.
하고 싶었던 그런 무대였었던 것 같습니다.
Which kind of brings up the question. Tell me a little bit about the difference that you see in audiences here in the United States than you might see at home in Korea or Japan.
Oh, that is an interesting question. That is actually an interesting question.
What's different about American audiences?
You know, you could feel it. Their heat, their energy.
Yeah.
You know, I want to say America is surely has the number one and the biggest music market in the world. Mm. So I guess I'm really careful, but I try to say the level of their audience is very, very high, mm. and they know how to play,
Yeah.
And
no, but for real, like, I believe like American audiences are like easy to fascinate about something, and like they are there to have a good show, and they are all in a good mood, and they are fired up, powered up, and you can really not say that about German audiences, at least.
And the biggest difference is, they can speak and they can sing along to all the Korean lyrics.
Yeah.
Even they're not Koreans.
Do you find that?
That must be so cool.
Unusual that here, this is arguably the biggest music market in the world, almost exclusively English speaking, and you are singing in Korean.
Yes, sir.
And they know every word.
Such a great impact.
That has to be.
They must be so proud.
Maybe
they must be so proud.
It's got to be somewhat surprising to you. Am I right?
네, 사실 이제 한국에도 이제 수많은 팝스타들이 내한을 오지만 모든 관객들이 모든 노래를 따라할 수는 없거든요. 근데 그걸 보면 아 정말 저희 팬 여러분들이 정말 대단하고 또 저희의 가사를 이해하기 위해서 많은 노력을 하셨구나라는 생각이 굉장히 들어서 감사하다는
That's true. That is so true.
And you know that's
I just love when Yoongi is like getting into the questions.
That's you know borne out by everything you see on social media, the way that your fans connect with you. But I want to talk about speaking of being, you know, somewhat different. So and
why is V biting his lips, guys? Why is that allowed?
You guys would know much better than me.
Please help.
There's a tradition, if you will, of these idol groups in Korea, K-pop bands that have come up before you. And when you were put together, when you guys got together, the intention was completely different. And I'm wondering if you could talk a little bit about the conversations once you got together that you had with Mr. Bong about I hope I got that right.
You got it right.
You know, about the formation of the band, the intention of the band, how the band would
And those are really good questions, I have to say. Really, really good and interesting questions with different like aspects than are normally asked.
So.
뭐 사실 뭐 결성 의도라기보다는 항상 방 PD님이 강조하던 게 있었어요. 특히 저희들이 이제 음악을 만들거나 했을 때 이제 우리가 겪고 우리가
And that
생각하고
is, that is what made BTS different. That is what made them different.
라는 말씀을 하셨어. 처음에 이제 저희가 모였을 때 뭐 7, 8년 전부터 음악을
Bang,
만들고
guys.
그때는 10대인 친구도 있었고 막 20대가 된 저도 있었고 굉장히 그런 것들을 위해
yeah,
노력을 많이 했던 게 지금의 방탄소년단을 만드는데 굉장히
yeah,
큰 포인트가 됐던 것 같아요.
We want to be a kind of like a method of help for the world. And Mr. Bang really
Oh, Mr. Bang. Oh, okay. Mr. Bang is right. Mr. Bang, okay.
To like you said intention we wanted to make his music and his artists like that, and we thought it too. We wanted to use our abilities and skills and our some inside inspirations to help the world.
To spread love.
It you know feed each other, Mr. Bang and us.
Yeah.
It made us into BTS.
Were you aware of the success that Mr. Bang had previously in K-pop? Were you aware of his work as a songwriter and a producer?
Of course we were aware of his success, but
I believe he's like a or he was like years ago too a big name and a respected man, I believe, but his company wasn't that big. That was the only problem, I would say.
No, that was not everything, because we thought his expertise thing is like actually, he was famous for some ballad
yeah.
songs, really slow tempo.
Uh-huh.
And you know, we started as like a kind of like a very powerful music
True.
and
True.
Those performances. So we were not like 100% sure of his vision and
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. But you I'm assuming you got you kind of worked that out together.
Namjoon looks so fancy. I don't know, the way he talks. It looks really fancy.
There. Yes, you know, with him. And one of the things that you've been very public about in terms of what concerns you are the pressures that teenagers face, particularly in Korea, but I think that that may translate to other countries as
well. Yeah, definitely.
Why is it important for you to speak about, to sing about, to write about the challenges that young people face in Korea?
뭐랄까 저도 이제 학창 시절을 겪으면서 굉장히 음악으로 이제 위로를 받거나 음악으로서 이제 돌파구들을 굉장히 많이 yeah. 느꼈었던 것 같아요. 근데 시간이 지남으로써 지금 돌이켜보니 10대 친구들, 20대 초반 친구들이 이제 음악을 들음으로써 이제 형성되는 가치관이라든지 굉장히 영향을 많이 주는 데도 불구하고 건강한 메시지라든지 또 건강한 이제 음악이 좀 없다는 데 좀 아쉬움을 느끼기도 했었고 플러스로 한국에 한정된 게 아닌 것 같아요. 이런 10대들 그리고
I feel like I could listen to Yoongi like all day. He's so smart and I don't know, he has so many good beautiful thoughts in his head and I don't know. He's definitely on my like top 5 list of people I would like to talk to for half an hour about anything. I don't know why, but I feel like he has so many interesting thoughts going on in his head. It's just like really, really nice, and in a way, it calms me in a way to listen to him. I don't know.
또 20대 청춘들이 느끼는 이제 아픔이라든지 슬픔이라든지 또 고민이라든지 이런 거는 전 세계 공통이라고 생각이 듭니다. 그래서 이제 공감되는 가사를 통해서 많은 분들이 위로를 받았으면 좋겠고 그걸 통해서
That is a beautiful, good intent.
건강한 음악들이 많아졌으면 하는 바람이 되게 컸었던 것 같아요.
True.
Here's what one of the things that immediately caught me watching your videos is the first thing you see is the slate that comes up for Big Hit Entertainment. And it says, and I'm sure you know this.
It says.
I'm sure you know this. It says music and artist for healing. Now I can assure you, I've never seen that on a Warner Brothers video.
No.
Or
you
a Sony
won't.
Music video.
You won't.
So tell me what that means to you. What does music and artist for healing mean to you guys?
That describes not only BTS but really Big Hit so well. I never thought about it like that deep, but it really is what BTS and like Big Hit and I haven't got into TXT, but maybe also TXT stands for.
I may have stumped him on this one.
Okay, so that was kind of like a promise that we and Mr. Bang had like right before our debut, so in 2013. And what we promised is like two things. We have to talk about, we want to, and we have to talk about what's really inside us and we want to be helpful to the world, and we want to say and speak and show something that this world needs, especially our friends, teenagers and 20s. So, life is supposed to be very ironic and unstable. And in teenage years and in 20s, it's really more and more. Like, we doubt ourselves.
True.
We're like, sometimes we want to live, sometimes we want to die. You know, it changes, you know, day to day, even by an hour. So music and artists for healing is that kind of it's like a big wide slogan, including like all of the like slogans we had.
Yeah.
We wanted to talk what's inside, and we wanted to help, we wanted to be an help for our friends in the world.
Let's talk a little bit about songwriting.
Damn.
Because you guys are very engaged in your songwriting process.
True.
And I'm wondering.
Not only were we engaged, like they are the songwriters.
For you, because it is, it's seven people. That's a lot of people to collaborate, if you will, on writing a song. So where does it start? How does a song start for you guys? Is it a lyric? Is it a melody? Is it a concept for a video? How does a song start for you?
사실 이제 뭐 일단 이 프로듀싱이라는 걸 봤을 때 저희는 앨범에 한정되지 않는다고 생각해. 뭐 앨범뿐만 아니라 뭐 춤이면 춤, 스타일링이면 스타일링 이런 모든 복합적인 걸 다 프로듀싱한다고 생각을 하는데
everything like every single
aspect. 기본적으로는 첫 번째는 음악이라고 생각을 해가지고. 사실 365일 송캠프가 진행된다고 생각하시면 됩니다. 저희 모두가 곡을 보내고 뭐 가사 생각나는 거 있으면 보내고 또 주제 생각나는 거 있으면 보내고 이렇게 이제 추합이 된 거를 사실 이제 방피디님이 정리를 해주시죠. 이건 이렇게 갔으면 좋겠고 저건 저렇게 갔으면 좋겠고 그런 식으로 이제 시작은 음악에서부터 출발을 해서
That is cool. That is a really great and healthy connection that I'm having with Mr. Bang, that like it is this healthy in and output, and they're like helping and building up on each other.
Sounds so good. 넘어가고 이렇게 가지를 쳐서 근데 그 모든 게 순차적으로 하나씩 진행된 게 아니라 거의 동시다발적으로 진행된다는 게 어떻게 보면 약간 좀 특별하다고 말씀드릴 수 있겠네요.
True.
Are you always writing songs?
그렇죠. 뭐 사실 일곱 명이 모두 각자의 그 맡은 부분들을 하려고 노력하는 중이고 각자 작사이면 작사, 작곡이면 작곡 많은 프로듀싱 부분에서 참여를 하고 있는 것 같아요. 그러다 보니까 뭔가 진실성이 더 큰 것 같고 그리고 뭔가 그런 저희의 에디튜드가 많이 달라지는 것 같아요. 그런 부분.
And that is what you can really feel and hear about the music.
That's fascinating. Is you take an idea, you know, let's just say the Love Yourself. Cycle, for lack of a better term, you take an idea and you go through stages, you know, in a way that I'm a little old, so I'm about to reference artists that none of these folks necessarily have heard of, but in my day there was a band called The Who, and The Who.
I've heard about that band actually. There's a famous song.
The Who wrote two different rock operas where they took a concept and they created a whole album, double album, of songs that told a very specific story, you know, from beginning, middle, to end. And it strikes me that you guys are doing exactly the same thing in your own way. But over you know the course of you know consecutive albums, so how is it that you've been able to kind of stick with that and come up with these concepts that you can follow over a period of time?
Yes. So like I said before, we want to find topics and we want to find stories, you know, in what is in our real mind. So when we, like 5 years ago, in our debut, like we talked about schools.
Yeah.
And we talked about schools with three albums. And then we talked about youth with three albums. And then folks grow up, right? Folks grow up. They're like,
it happens.
Some more than other, but yeah.
They kind of like grew up. We're not going to school anymore, and you know, like, our attitude to life is kind of like a change a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
And we thought, what we could talk now, and the most story that world need is the love, and you know, but love, you know, is kind of like a very abstract, and it's very wide. So, we started with that. We started with that phrase. I don't know where it really came from, but somebody said love is a ability. I mean, it's so many people mistake love with be in love
or fall in love.
But many people, especially teenagers and young years, they just fall in love. They thought, they think they're really in love, but they, but there's like no details into it. So
yeah,
But if somebody doesn't love themselves, then they
it all starts there.
Love nobody. It was the same. It was also the same. Mr. Bond came up with it, and we thought it was really great. And we were really young, and sometimes we do some mistakes too. So we said we wanted to do this whole project with 4-part series. And you know, it's really, really common to proceed stories with 4-part in Korea.
Yeah.
So we do it with 4-part series, 3 albums and 1 video. Hmm. So there's a kind of like a stage, like you said. We meet someone, and then we thought we fell in love. But someday we just must know that, oh, we're different. We're not just the same person.
Mm.
You're not that one that I expected, and then we break up, and then, but what's in our real mind was that I just never loved myself, so I could like love no one.
Mm.
So it's really hard to express this in English, but
yeah,
I'm
you're
trying.
You're doing fine.
I'm trying.
He did really good.
You're doing fine.
So that's what we found out, and we've been doing this like for 2 years.
I'm so proud of Namjoon that he's doing all of that in English. That is some deep stuff. That is some deep stuff that like is... I kind of get the feeling because I'm also not a native speaker, so I can understand it even more like some of you, but I believe... Well, most of my viewers are also not native English, so you will understand it too, but it is really, really hard to express some deep, deep thoughts. Those are like really deep thoughts, and not your native language. So, huge respect for him, and he pulled it off really well.
2 years and a half.
Yeah.
So it's like really risky, kind of like to proceed this like for quite a long time, because this music industry is really fast these days, right? And the streaming world, like every good music and album is coming out like day by day. So, but we took risks, and you know, thanks to our fans, they react to us, and they felt us. They said, they told us that they became to love themselves like a little more, even a little more, thanks to this album.
It must be such a great feeling to read that.
We made ourselves like to think about what loving ourselves really means.
Yeah.
So that was the real thing of this album.
And did that begin with Cypher 4?
Well, like about the interviewer, like he did his research and he's really interested to get to know them better and to get to know their thoughts. And that is why I like this interview a lot. The interview is really good.
Is that where that...
What they said?
With Cypher 4? Is that...
Oh, I haven't heard Cypher 4 yet. I haven't heard Cypher 4 yet. But you guys told me I need to check it out. I will.
Is that where that started?
I think so. Actually, I came
up
with
that
phrase.
I love the fact that you laugh when I...
yeah.
I may be old, but I'm not clueless.
You know that track. Gosh.
No, but I mean, that's not...
He's younger than us. I mean, like, mentally.
Sorry. Let's not get carried away.
Sorry, I'm not being rude.
But that song talks about love myself. It's almost like a, for lack of a better term, a mantra that you are expressing to your audience.
Yes.
전 뭐 사실 저희 음악들은
the best answer. Yes.
음악마다 유기성이 굉장히 있어가지고 한 노래만 듣고서는 어떻게 보면 이 전체 스토리나 전체 주제라든지 앨범을 파악하기엔 좀 힘들 수도 있다는 생각이 좀
들어요. Yeah, I get that.
그래가지고 필시 부탁드리는 거는 앨범 전체를 다 들어봐 주셨으면 좋겠다는 말씀 꼭 드리고 싶어요.
And how important to the story arc are the videos?
Really important. Really important. Well, some more than others, but in general, really important.
To conceive and perform.
Does that
help you tell the stories that are important to you?
사실 애초에 저 앨범 컨셉이 나와 있고 그 중에서 가장 흔히 많이 듣는 타이틀이라는 곡을 뮤직비디오를 찍는데 그 앨범 색깔이 가장 잘 묻어 있어요. 그
yes.
비디오에. 그래서
yeah.
뭔가를 이제 그 앨범의 색깔을 알고 싶고 우리가 말하고 싶 이번 앨범에서 말하고 싶은 걸 보고 싶다면 그 앨범의 타이틀 뮤직비디오를 보는 게 맞다고 할 수 있죠.
Are there current artists? Not necessarily, you know, K-pop artists from long ago, whether it was Big Bang, you know, or others, but current artists.
He really did his research even into like K-pop history. I like him a lot. Such a great interview.
Maybe in the U.S., maybe around the world, that are influencing your thinking or your approach to
that
your
inspires
song and
you.
Your music. Who are you listening to?
Okay, so who are they listening to? Eminem, Drake, Childish Gambino, but those are like modern artists. I don't know. Maybe the Beatles, even they were referenced a few times. But if Yoongi says something, Eminem is gonna be involved. If Namjoon says something, Drake is gonna be involved.
저는 저는 뭐 가요 이제 한국 노래 이제 가요도 많이 듣고
okay, yeah.
또 팝.
He's open-minded. That's good.
네. 좀 구분 지으려고 하지 않아요. 그래서 되게 여러 장르로 접하려고 하고 있고 또 뭐 영어 노래면 가사를 찾아서 뭐 그 가사에서 영감을 좀 받는다거나 뭐 정말 수많은 곡들이 많기 때문에 저는 요즘은 이제 그런 거 다 제외하고 그냥 다 올
He's really open-minded.
Which prompts a question. Do you think of K-pop as we know it here, you know, our understanding of K-pop as a genre? Do you think that it has qualities separate and apart from other types of music?
That is hard. Like in K-pop, they are like subgenres, so it is hard to say what is even K-pop or what is not K-pop because I wouldn't say K-pop is really a genre because there are so many different genres in K-pop that it is hard to label as a genre. I don't know. It's hard.
사실 뭐 여기서 이렇게 이야기한 게 좀 조심스러운
yeah.
게 뭔가 K-pop을
can't understand that,
정립을
yeah.
하는 듯해서 약간 좀 뭔가 말 좀 조심스럽게 해야 될 것 같은데 뭔가 장르로서 저는 그렇게 생각해요. 장르로서 접근한다기보다는 그냥 하나의
yeah.
복합적인 컨텐츠로 접근을 하는 게 오히려 맞지 않나라는 생각이 들거든요. 특히나 이 K-pop이라는 거를 이해하기 위해서는 음악도 음악이고 영상이면 영상, 의상이면
There's so many aspects to it.
뭐 이 모든 것들이 전부 다 이 한 대 어울려져서 이게 시각적으로 또 청각적으로 들리는 이 보이는 것들이
Auditory content package. That is a great way to put it.
기존에 있던 형태들과는 좀 많이 다르다고 생각이 들거든요.
Yes.
그렇기 때문에 한 가지 장르로서 K-pop을 접근한다기보다는 좀 복합적인 문화 콘텐츠로 접근하는 게 오히려 좀 더 쉽지 않을까라는 생각이 좀 드네요.
Oh, I really love that we get to hear Yoongi so much.
From a lot of different sources. You know, there's, you know, clearly there's balladry, there's, you know, music that you might hear in a club. There is rap.
Yeah.
The elements of R&B, EDM, I mean, you draw from a lot of different sources, you know, in the process. Tell me a little bit about kind of the relationship with your production team, because in any recording project, and I'm sure you've learned this, the relationship between artist and producer can make or break the success of any
yeah,
any
true.
Recording. So tell me how you work with your production team. What's that process like?
사실 회사를 가면 the production team의 층이 있는데 그 층에 저희가 거의 저희 작업실도 있고요. 뭐 저희가 이제 쉴 수 있는 공간도 있고요. 사실 프로듀서들과 굉장히 긴밀한 관계를 유지하면서 동업자임을 동시에 인지하고 있으면서 그러면서 또 음악은 또 음악대로 만드는데 가감 없이 이제 상하 관계가 아닌 정말 동등한 입장에서 가감 없이 이야기를 하는 편이고
That is good.
앨범 작업에 들어가면
That is a good work environment.
뭐 거의 같이 생활을 한다시피 하니까요. 아까도 말씀드렸듯이 365일 송캠프를 진행하는 느낌이라는 생각이 들 정도로 정말 편안하고, 특히나 창작하는 데 있어가지고 이제 저희의 이제 아이디어나 저희의 생각들을 정리해준 프로듀서들이랑 거리감이 있다면 결과물이 좋지 않을 거라 생각이 드는데,
That's true.
저희는 그 관계를 굉장히 최소화시켰고, 그렇기 때문에 빠른 시간에 다양한 장르의 또 퀄리티 좋은 음악들을 만들어낼 수 있다고 생각이 들어요.
More specifically, I want to say like a it's like a good competition with our production team, because you know good is always good and better is always better.
Yeah.
So
true, very true.
Of course, in tracks, of course, in melodies and lyrics. You try to like a compete. So if somebody guess without comes up with a better one,
right?
And we use that. So we're like a good colleagues, but in the same like a business team or a classroom.
Uh-huh.
We want to show our teacher a better.
Yeah, I get that. It's like a tiny competition, like tiny way of show off. Like, okay, that beat is fire, but let's see what I can do. And then it gets better and better every time.
Yeah, so it's very good and
yeah.
healthy. And healthy, yeah. Definitely.
So it's seven guys in the band.
Yes.
I can't expect that you all always agree on a song, a lyric, a step, whatever it might be. How do you resolve disagreements? Well, first of all, do you have disagreements? Do you have disagreements about maybe writing a song or
yeah,
the way...
Sure.
You know, the way a certain choreographed
move should
work.
But we read if they didn't, so it's natural.
How do you figure that out?
사실 진짜,
I mean, we're humans.
진짜 저희도 되게 냉정한 것 같긴 해요. 아닌 건 아닌 거고, 이거는 별로인 거는 별로인 거라고 확실히 말하는 것 같고.
That is important. That is really important.
그리고 안무적인 부분에서도 저희가 이제 장기적으로 봤을 때 이런 부분에서는 체력적으로 많이 소모가 되고, 그리고 멤버들 이제 건강 문제도 있으니까 아까 말했다시피 저희도 한 해 한 해마다 이제 나이가 이제 하고 있고, 그러다 보니까 이제 안무적인 부분에서도 많이 수정을 하고 이런 부분에서 드랙을 많이 주는 것 같아요. 네.
네, 이거는 저희가 녹음 같은 걸 진행할 때도 이런 부분들이 좀 있는 것 같긴 해요. 항상 멤버들이 좋은 멜로디와 좋은 가사를 만들어 주고 있지만, 뭔가 노래를 녹음하면서 아 이거는 좀 아닌데 라는 부분들이 좀 있을 때가 있어요. 그럴 때는 저희끼리 다 같이 모여서 뭐 음악을 같이 들어보면서 더 좋은
yeah.
방향성으로 갈 수 있게 저희끼리 얘기를 좀 많이 하면서 계속 진행을 하는 것 같아요.
존중이 있기 때문 또 있는 것 같아요. 싸우질 않아요 저희는.
Yes.
그냥 서로 의견을 듣고 인정을 하고
I mean, they're like
수정할
brothers,
방법을
so.
생각하지 동의하지 않는다고 해서 왜 동의하지 않는다고 접근을 하지 않거든요.
To speak to one
so
another.
We only have a couple minutes left. And I want to ask you a couple things. First of all, in a very self-interested kind of way, I know you guys got to walk a little bit around the Grammy Museum. What did you think about the Grammy Museum?
Yeah. Good. Awesome.
Did Cookie say that?
Yeah. Good.
Yeah.
Awesome.
No. Oh, okay. Okay.
이 그래미의 역사를 뭔가 yeah, 한 눈에 볼 수 있어서 너무 좋았었던 것 같아요.
Let.
Let. True though.
Maybe we'll see you on the Grammy stage someday. 그래미 무대도.
Please.
They did, right? They did a performance. No, they didn't. They didn't perform, but didn't they announce something? They did something at the Grammys. I believe they were on the stage. They were on the stage, right? They didn't won. And they didn't perform, but I believe they presented something. I have no idea.
Sure. So, as is evidenced by, you know, the 200 people sitting in the room here, you have a remarkable relationship with your fans. In a way that perhaps few...
Jim, like, immediately looking into the audience, giving death stares, like, and getting girls pregnant by his looks.
...ship with your fans. In a way that
pregnant,
perhaps
pregnant,
few
pregnant.
Artists today enjoy. Why is this relationship so important to you?
Because... Oh! Guys. Finally! finally Taeyang is gonna say something. I waited for that. Okay. Because the difference is we really matter to them. That is the difference.
왜냐면 팬분들이 저에게 날개를 달아준 거 같이 저희를 이곳까지 올려준 주었기 때문에 팬들하고 관계는 되게 가까울 수밖에 없을 것 같아요.
사실 저희의 성적들은 뭐 저희가 만들었다기보다는 저희 팬분들과 함께 했기 때문에
yeah, that is so true.
좋은 결과들이 있었다고 생각하고요. 지금 공연도 뭐 저희만 하는 게 아니라 정말 많은 분들이 저희와 함께 하고 있다고 생각을 합니다.
Yeah. So last question. Second album now. Top of the Billboard 200 in the United States. Within 4 months. I'm
Easy.
Not sure any Easy. Other band has done that. I haven't done my research, but I think that's that you may be the first. What does that kind of recognition mean to you?
뭐 그만큼 뭔가 저희의 어떤 위치를 보여주는 것 같아요. 그래서 그 위치만큼 뭔가 좀 더 책임감이나 뭐 부담감이나 이런 게 좀 많이 든 것 같아요. 그래서
yeah.
뭐 음악적으로나 뭐 행동이나 모든 면에서 뭔가 그 위치에 따른 거기에 맞는 그런 모든 것도 좀 맞춰야 하는 그런 마음가짐이 좀 생긴 것 같아요. 개인적으로.
Well, all we know is you have done terrifically well. We wish you nothing but the best. I know you guys are off on you're going around America, North America. I heard something about Canada. Enjoy the shows and thank you so much for coming.
Thank you,
Mr.
Gomes.
Thank you so much.
Meet you.
Thank you.
What a wonderful interview. What a wonderful interview. I know this video is quite long and I want to thank everybody who's watching till now. If you're still watching, comment down below. Still watching. Comment. Wait, do it with a hashtag. Hashtag still watching. Hashtag still watching. I'm really excited to see how many are still watching. But for real, thank you guys for watching so long. And that was such a great interview. So many good and thoughtful questions and so many good and thoughtful answers. Especially from Yoongi. Damn, that was great. I enjoyed that a lot. Can't believe I've sat here 40 minutes. 40 minutes. And time flies by like nothing watching that. I don't know. That was just great. That was just great. And as I said, huge props to the interviewer. He did his research. He was like genuine interested in them. And he really wanted to get to know them better. So huge respect to him and the Grammy Museum. That was great. I enjoyed it a lot, guys. If there are more interviews, I should watch. Nothing from the late night shows because that usually gets blocked. And I already have a strike, which runs out in 2 months. So I really don't want to get another one before that runs out. So maybe after that we can try it. But if there are some interviews that are good, comment down below. I will check them out. And yeah, thank you all for watching. Don't forget to smile today. Have a wonderful, bright and beautiful day. And see you soon with the next one.